डॉक्टर काकोडकर, श्री चौगले, डॉक्टर थाट्टे, डॉक्टर फोनके, डॉक्टर भाटकर, डॉक्टर बागुल, द डिस्टिंग्विश साइंटिस्ट इन द ऑडियंस एंड मेंबर्स ऑफ बोथ विज्ञान भारती मुंबई एंड कीर्ति कॉलेज. It is indeed an honor for me to stand before you and receive all the felicitations. In fact, I was wondering that I still have a few years to go, why you are felicitating me at this stage. I'll just touch upon only one point because this is not a time to make a big speech. I think many a time I have been asked this question, that how easy or difficult it was to stepping into the shoes of Dr. Kakodkar. So let me address that. So obviously it is not a very easy thing. The responsibilities are heavy, and more importantly, the time at which this is happening, when our program is witnessing a very, very accelerated growth. We are talking of the nuclear power production in the country. We have reached a level of about 4,500 megawatt of installed capacity. And today what we are planning is in another 10 to 12 years, this will come to close to 35,000 megawatt. So the program is expanding in such a large way, there are many challenges. I'll just touch upon one or two challenges and also some of the constraints. You just now heard the, in response to the question, whether the embargo has been a blessing in disguise for us. It is so. From 1974 onwards, that we have been embargoed against practically any import in the area of nuclear energy has made us to develop everything indigenously. I must also acknowledge the participation of Indian industry in making this possible. It is not just only a scientific research on a bench scale, but translating that into a large-scale industrial product. And whatever is possible today is, it has been mainly because there's a very good association of this development on the scientific laboratory and pushing that to the industry, which has finally given the shape to all the things that we have developed. So now, in once again, a situation has come that when we are talking of coming from this 4,500 megawatt to nearly 35,000, there's a big change. The whole industry will get sort of catalyzed to such a growth pattern, which is itself is a very big challenge. Very few countries can take up a challenge of this nature. And in this context, I also must mention that there is a general feeling that this additional capacity will be done mostly by import. This is one point which I want to explain to you, that you have been hearing that there will be a large-scale import of nuclear power plants. It is exactly not the same. Out of this, from present 4,500 to 35,000, in about 12 years, we are planning to have our indigenous reactor, 700 megawatt, 10 of them. So 7,000 megawatt comes straight from that. Our present fast breeder reactor will become complete, and we'll add a few more of the fast breeder reactor. And typically in this period, we are thinking something like about 20,000 megawatt of light water reactor to be installed in the country. The light water reactor of 1000 megawatt plus capacity is with definitely foreign technologies, but we were just analyzing that how much will be the localization of the product of those. It is nearly about 70 to 80%, even today's context, of this will be made in India. It is not going to be imported. We are not making a single step that these will be turnkey projects. These are not. All the projects will be handled by Nuclear Power Corporation. So it will be Nuclear Power Corporation NPCIL's reactors, which will be installed here primarily with the efforts of Indian industry. We may take a few critical components from abroad, and even from that there has been attempt that how much more indigenization we can do in next few years. I can also mention that we already have a joint venture with Larsen and Toubro to make these large size forgings so that the pressure vessels can be made in the country. Reactor pressure vessel is one of the major component of light water reactors. So when we are talking of this embargo, this has helped us in building this overall capability in the making the reactors, the complete thing, and also its complete fuel cycle. I think there are not even two or three countries in the world who can say that they have the mastery of the entire technology of reactor building and also the entire reactor fuel cycle. This has been possible mainly because of this embargo, and we can say that today when we talk of a Indian PHWR, it is really 100% Indian. Dr. Kakodkar in the last 1 year or so has been talking about the way forward. See, we have plans, and many a time I hear that question, that as he has now laid down his office and I have taken over, what is the new change that is coming? Actually, in our department, we don't consider it is so much individualistic. There is a plan and we carry on the plan as scheduled. So there is no change. And the one answer is that there will be no change at all. But there is this way forward. When we went into the direction of now the nuclear industry or nuclear business is opened up internationally, so we may be able to get some reactors which will be in the safeguarded systems or safeguarded domain, and in these reactors it is possible for us to get some components from abroad, and we are obviously negotiating with several countries. It is Russia, France, United States, in fact also with South Korea. So with several countries we have been having negotiations and seeing that what are the technologies which are coming from these countries, and we can install these what we call energy parks on the coastal sites. We are thinking of making energy parks. Each of the energy park will be producing something close to about 10,000 megawatt of installed capacity. They'll have maybe 6 to 8 reactors, each of them about 1,000 megawatt plus. Some of them, largest one is 1650 megawatt. So that is on the coastal side. Our own reactors, which is 700 megawatt PHWR, can be also installed in the inland sites, and there has been a few sites selected, and we are going to install these reactors as well. In addition to this, in fact this morning only, we are taking up this way forward business and talking of what we are going to do in immediate future. Way forward actually gives us a profile for next 40-50 years. But we wanted to pick up the first part of it, that is in next 10 to 12 years, because we are now working for completion of the 11th plan and going to the 12th plan and maybe up to the 13th plan. These are the plan period where we can talk of very specifics. It is not any general thing. It is not something which is a projection of the future. It is something, a reality, which is going to come in a very short time. While we did that, it was very clear, this morning only we are doing a complete survey of these possible technologies which will be adopted, and we find that this is indeed possible to come to this kind of a level. Our main challenge today is another type. We have one technology, that is pressurized heavy water reactor technology, which is 100% Indian. Today some other light water reactor technologies from different countries are coming in. So our next major challenge is, we have to show that our technology is no way inferior, in fact in several ways superior to that we can get from outside.